Welcome to this latest video from simple-bbq.com. Today I'm making brioche buns for burgers, and I absolutely love them, and this is how I go about doing it. So this being simple BBQ, I'm using a breadmaker to help me make the dough up, but of course you can make this by hand, or you could use a mixing machine, anything that's capable of making dough up. And at the bottom in the YouTube description here, I'll give you the recipe for the brioche ingredients. So with everything in, I'm going to put this onto a dough mix mode on the bread maker, and I'm going to leave it to do what it does best, which is mix all these ingredients together, and gives it a little bit of warmth to help with it to rise. Now that my bread maker's finished and the dough's risen, I'm just going to put a little bit of flour on the worktop here, and I'm going to take the dough from the bread maker. You can see that's risen nicely, and you have to trust me when I tell you it just smells absolutely delicious. So I'm going to lay this dough out on the flour, and then we have to just go through a process that's called knocking back. So I'm just going to knock it back a little bit, not too much, and start forming the bread rolls. So I'm just going to make this ball of dough roughly uniform so that I can then divide it up, and I'm looking to make 4 bread rolls from this mix. So if you want to make more bread rolls than the ingredients given below, just adjust the quantity accordingly. So with all bread dough, you have to be careful not to overwork the dough, and that's not something that's easily quantified or qualified, but you just have to basically attempt to keep the amount of contact time with the dough to a minimum. And during this time you're looking to shape the roll, but what you can't afford to do, because it will rise in a funny way, is fold the dough over. So always, in this case I'm just flattening it out like a pizza dough basically, to make a bit of a disc. If you should fold it, you then need to make sure that you fold any loose ends underneath, and then kind of push that back into the dough so it makes more a ball again. And if it folds over, you can end up with a pocket, which is then going to make it rise awkwardly and leave you with a funny shaped bread roll. So that's a couple made, and we'll just jump to the last one now. You can see just pulling it, stretching it out, not pushing it, not squashing it, but just shaping it. And now these rolls are going to go somewhere warm to continue to rise again, and you're looking for them to double in size. So now my bread rolls have more or less doubled in size and they're looking good. I'm going to put a wash over the top, which is made from egg and milk. Again, details below in the description that will explain what's in the wash. And just making sure to give all these rolls a really good covering. This will complement or improve the colour and really look good once they've been cooked. No need to be careful about this, just make sure you've got everything covered. And one last thing I didn't mention earlier is the tray. It's a standard oven tray. I've put foil on the bottom so it doesn't ruin it when it goes into the barbecue in a minute. And I've just put some oil on the surface to stop things sticking. So I'm cooking these on the barbecue, but you could easily cook them in the oven. Set it out, got it nice and hot, cooking in the indirect method. So tray goes in, lid goes on, turn the lid about 10 minutes or so in, and I'm going to cook these bread rolls for about 20-25 minutes. You'll probably cook them for less time in the oven. And here they are, looking great. Got a lovely colour on the top, as you can see. Risen well, rose a little bit more whilst they were in the heat of the barbecue, and I'm going to let these cool down and eat some burgers tonight. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe.